offense to you. And I'm sorry about that. I'm just gonna start at the beginning with the house.
Key in the woods.
Someone had put up a chain link fence, but it looked like I wasn't the first person to hop it. My brother Milton disappeared when I was 4. It was like the house just swallowed him up.
Okay. I think she's looking for her brother. Power lines.
I lived here until I was 11. But I wasn't allowed inside half the rooms.
Right, so I'm just going to play this and just see how it goes. So I'll come after the mic and just play.
Inside the mailbox were bills from 7 years ago, marked urgent, open immediately. I hadn't been back since my brother Lewis's funeral. In her will, my mother left me a key but didn't tell me what it unlocked. Maybe she thought I'd know. Or she thought the mystery would be enough to bring me back. The truth is, even after I inherited the house, I never thought I'd come back to it. But now I had questions about my family that only the house knew the answers to. The woods around the house have always been uncomfortably silent. As if they're about to say something, but never do. The house was exactly like I remembered it, the way I'd been dreaming about it. As a child, the house made me uncomfortable in a way I couldn't put into words. Now, as a 17-year-old, I knew exactly what those words were. I was afraid of the house. I hoped the key might unlock the front door. It didn't. Looking in, I felt like the house itself had been waiting for me. The house felt like it had always been here. Even the swing set was older than my mother. Crawling through the doggy door used to be a lot easier when I was 11. The power had been turned off the night we left. For the first time in years, I felt like I was home. But instead of a family, there were just memories of one. Like how only one restaurant would deliver to our house, so we had Chinese a lot. Or how after Louis started working at the cannery, we all got sick of eating salmon. Except our cat, Molly. The table was still a wreck from the night we left. It was like a bomb had gone off, killing everyone but sparing the furniture. Nothing in the house looked abnormal. There was just too much of it, like a smile, too many teeth. Even the fireplace had a story. Edie told me the bricks came from the original house, after it sank. Great-grandpa Sven built a music box for Barbara, along with the rest of the house. Edie told me once that every Finch who ever lived is buried somewhere in the library. A lot of things got left behind in the whirlwind of that last night. My mom wasn't much of an optimist, but she never stopped believing that my brother Milton was alive. After Milton disappeared, Mom sealed up all the bedrooms. Then Edie retaliated and drilled peepholes. Molly always seemed like a girl I could imagine being friends with, if she hadn't died in 1947. I spent a lot of time playing in Great Uncle Walter's room. I think my mom sometimes regretted not sealing it up. Lewis told me there were secret passages, but I never believed him. Turns out, my mom was really good at keeping secrets. Now it was time to find out what my mom had been afraid of. From the paintings on the wall, it was clear my brother Milton had been here before me. Reading this, maybe it sounds like I had a plan. But I had no idea what was behind that door. Just like I had no idea where all this was gonna lead. I grew up looking at Molly's room through the peephole. Molly's gerbil had a tiny bedroom with its own even tinier gerbil cage. Being inside for the first time, I felt like I'd stepped behind a painting. I got the sense Edie had spent a lot of time here before my mom sealed the doors.
December 13th, 1947. Dear Diary, I'll be gone soon, but I wanted to tell somebody about what's gonna happen. It started when Mom sent me to bed without dinner. I woke up and I was starving, so I looked around for something to eat. The gerbil food was dry, but I didn't mind it. Christopher, but I held back. Mom, can I come out now?
Sweetheart, it's late. Go to sleep.
My Halloween candy was all gone. I kept eating and eating. I ate a lot of things that night. Then I heard chirping outside my window. It was a barn swallow going back to her nest. I reached out for her. Suddenly, I was a cat. I tried to be quiet, but the bird was really scared. The babies were all gone. jumped and I almost got her. I could tell she was getting really tired. Now I was up in the big tree. I promised Dad I wouldn't climb it anymore. All I cared about was eating that mama bird. I gobbled her up. And suddenly, I was an owl. First, all I heard was the wind. Then I heard little teeth nibbling in the grass. A mama rabbit. She was almost too big to carry. I started choking, but I couldn't stop eating. And suddenly, I was a shark. Into the ocean. Now, I was hungrier than ever. I wanted fat, juicy seals. Everything had changed. Now I was a monster and I smelled people everywhere. was big, but I moved real quiet.
Good smell went into an old pipe.
I got closer and closer. All my stomach started growling. And suddenly, I was me again. I held my breath for a long time, but I couldn't hear anything. I think it's waiting for me to fall asleep. But it's not going to wait much longer. It needs to be.
I'm not sure if I believed all of that, but I'm sure Edie would have.